Okay, welcome back. Today we are going to enter into an interesting concept which is called as available energy. But before that, I want you to tell you something about second law of thermodynamics. See, when I started discussing second law of thermodynamics, I said that second law of thermodynamics is very rich conceptual. It throws many interesting concepts. And now one more concept, and the concept is that of quality of energy. Now you know that we always have come across quantity of energy, right? We haven't come across quality of energy. But second law brings in this concept of quality of energy. Like, look at this. Consider heat. Compare it with work. Now, you know second law tells you that for any engine working in a cycle, it's impossible for that engine to convert all the heat given to it into work. Some heat has to be rejected, right? So, conversion of heat into work by an engine working in cycle fully is not possible, and this is what second law tells you, right? That's what is second law. Whereas, conversion of work into heat, 100%, yes, it is possible. So heat cannot be fully converted into work by an engine which is working in cycle, but the reverse is possible. Of course, the second law is talking about only conversion of heat into work. But this also tells you that there is, see, in terms of units, both work and heat have the same unit. They are basically forms of energy. So it is second law which is giving you some direction. That means it is telling that there is intrinsic limit on conversion of heat into work, right? So it is telling that in a way it is distinguishing between these two forms of work, that so heat in this sense is, compared to work, is a lower grade of energy. So here we are bringing in the quality aspect. So certain forms of energies are of high grade, certain forms are low grade. For example, mechanical work, it's a high grade energy. Electricity, it's a high grade energy. A fluid flowing in a jet or water jet, it's a high grade energy. Okay, but heat, on the other hand, it could be because of coming from nuclear fuel or burning of coal, whatever. But whatever, heat, compared to these forms of energies, is a low grade energy. So heat is a low grade energy. Why? Because that's what I just told you, that conversion. Look at the conversion. So look at conversion between, I said, electricity, electrical energy, mechanical energy. I categorize them as high grade energy. So think about the efficiencies of efficiency of electric motor. It's very, very high, right? It could be over 90%. That means electricity converted into mechanical energy. Similarly, mechanical energy converted into electricity, generators. So there also efficiency is very, very high, because it's conversion from high grade energy to another high grade energy. But look at any technology where heat is converted into mechanical energy, and of course then electricity. There you find the efficiencies are very low. I mean, you can improve upon them, but there is an intrinsic limit, and that limit is because of the nature of your input form of energy, which is which is a low grade energy, right? Heat is a low grade energy. That's why it is not possible to have very high efficiencies. So you can improve technology and all that, but there is an intrinsic limitation. I might say more about this. So it's second law which categorizes the different forms of energy into two classes. One is high grade energy, other is low grade energy. An example of low grade energy is heat, right? Heat coming from any source, but basically heat. And example of high grade energies, I just told you, electricity, mechanical energy, of course, and wind energy, which are ordered form of flow of fluid, I mean jet, fluid flowing in the form of jet. All these are examples of high grade